Hello viewers and welcome to our weekly program Economic Insights. This afternoon we are blessed to be hosting the BancABC Chief Executive Dr. Lance Mambondiani, whom we have just caught up with during the commemorations of the Customer Service Week, an event which is held once a week annually. Welcome, Dr. Mambondiani.
No, thank you very much. Thank you for welcoming me. And I just wanted, of course, to say special thanks to you as a newspaper and as a publication. I have known New Zimbabwe for a very, very long time. And your history of impartiality and providing good and balanced news to all Zimbabweans is well appreciated. Thank you for having me.
It's a pleasure, Dr. Mambondiani. Maybe just to start with, I would like to ask you about what you think about these commemorations.
Well, as you know, this week we are celebrating the Customer Services Week, and this is an event that is celebrated worldwide by organizations, really, just to appreciate, you know, the customers who make our businesses and also the customer service professionals who are in the forefront, or as we call it, in the front line of serving, our various customers. Because all our businesses exist because of the customers who walk through us, whether it's New Zimbabwe, it's BancABC, whatever organizations that we represent, we exist because we have customers, we patronage our products and our services. So we just wanted to take an opportunity really to appreciate our customers and also to appreciate our staff who are doing an incredible work really of raising customer service, and really treating our customers with dignity, with empathy and with respect when they come through our doors.
Okay, so what do you think about the nature of customer service in Zimbabwe? Do we have any areas of improvement which you think companies need to focus on?
Well, I believe that there is an incredible work that needs to be done. I think all of us need to do more. And as I was saying earlier when I was speaking to our guests, is that it doesn't matter that one organization is performing superior or well in customer service. Usually a customer service is a culture, right? It's a philosophy. And that philosophy comes straight from the country on who we are as a people and as a country. So as far as I'm concerned, I think that I would like to say that customer service is something that we can all improve on as a country. It's all something that we can improve on as organizations. And I think that there's a lot of work that is already happening in the background. And as you know, CCA is in the forefront of trying to build a service culture within the country and a service culture within organizations with some of the things that we do. So although we have a lot of work, I also know that there's tremendous work that is happening within organizations. And I think that we owe it to ourselves as a nation and as an organization, really, to improve the manner and the way in which we treat each other as customers and as human beings.
Okay, Dr. Mambondiani, turning to your financials, I understand you've just reported your half-year financial performance. Did you manage to strike any profits?
I just want to say that we have witnessed quite a tremendous progress in our numbers in the half year that we've just reported, and there are a number of things that we look at, but the most important thing to me is not how profitable we've been as a business, because profitability for me is a measure of the trust that the customers are showing in the product and the service that we offer. So we've witnessed an increase in the number of people who are utilizing our products and our services. We've witnessed an increase in the number of customers, almost double. I think we were close to about 230,000 customers in the last period, in the same period last year. We've now seen that number increase to about 380 or so. So we're extremely happy with the number of customers that are coming and entrusting us with their service. Also, the number of customers who are using some of our digital platforms. We are happy with some of the work that we are doing with corporates, with SMEs, and some of the loans that we are advancing them so that they can just continue with some of the projects that they are doing. That's what we exist as financial intermediators. The numbers are an indication really of the support that we are given by our customers. But I must say to you that we have one stated goal, and our stated goal is really to be one of the top five financial services firm in this country. And I'm happy to say that we are on course to achieving that goal, and I'm quite excited that we are achieving that goal together with our customers, and because our customers have stuck with us, regardless of the difficulties that we've seen under COVID, and also regardless of the fact that our customers have choices in an area or in a field in which we know that there are many other banks who are offering the same products that we do.
Okay, so now, do you have any products which you are offering or which are suitable, which are suitable for those in the diaspora?
Oh, in the diaspora, there's many things that we are in the process of doing and cooking. In fact, some of the products that we launched in the last 6 months or so are really, really with the diaspora in mind. If I talk about Branch X, for example, Branch X is a product that allows anybody, no matter where you are, whether you are internal or you are external, to offer some of the banking services and products that we offer. As I speak to you, we are piloting a product that allows anybody to open an account on our website. Anybody can open an account as well through our WhatsApp banking proposition. So I absolutely believe that banking right now should be borderless. It's something that it doesn't matter that somebody is in the diaspora or in Zimbabwe. Anybody should be able to offer and access banking services through some of our platform services. So I believe that our customers in the diaspora have the capacity of extending our payment products, our products in remittances. As you know, we've partnered with Sendito, we've partnered with World Remit, we've partnered with a number of other institutions like MoneyGram, again for people in the diaspora who want to send money to their loved ones. WhatsApp banking again is something that I believe is quite critical in just breaking that border. And the reason we do it is because, as I always say, that banking is necessary, but banks are not. And what is important in that statement, in our philosophy, in the products that we offer, is that it doesn't matter where you are. We want to offer you a service, a banking service, regardless of the country, whether you are in the UK, whether you're in the US, whether you are in Australia. You can still access our services online on our website. You can access our services on WhatsApp. You can also access our service through branches, as I said before. And again, that for us is providing that bridge that is needed by those who want to access financial services, banking services, no matter where they are located.
Okay, as we round off, Dr. Mambondiani, what would be your last word to your customers out there?
It's been an extremely difficult year for all of us, and I'm speaking as a representative of one of the organizations in the country. I know it's been difficult as well worldwide. We know that there's been a significant impact on revenues in many, many areas, including household. Personally, I know that people have been hit quite significantly. I just want to thank all the customers who still choose us as a service provider despite the difficulties that they are experiencing. And I just want to say that I know that it's extremely hard in Zimbabwe, especially with some of the economic challenges that we have seen in the last few days. I'm encouraged by some of the things that we are seeing on stability on the foreign currency market, whether that stability is here to last or not. I think all of us are hopeful, and all of us really as Zimbabweans, and I believe that our future is only certain if we have put our hands together and build this one country that we have. We only have one Zimbabwe. If we don't build it, who else is going to do it? So I'm calling on all your readers and all your customers, no matter where they are, to put their hands together and make sure that we are working in unity to build the country that we love.
Well, thank you so much for your time, Dr. Mambondiani.
Thank you very much, and I appreciate being here. And thanks again to all your readers and your listeners.
Well, viewers, our program has come to an end. For these and more stories, please do not hesitate to visit our website, www.newszimbabwe.com, our TV channel, online TV channel, News Zimbabwe, NewsZimTV, our Facebook page, newszimbabwe.com. Otherwise, have a pleasant viewing.